Like, it's done until Apple files. It's done. And Apple, obviously, in litigation with Qualcomm.
With Qualcomm, yeah. Right, the growth name, certainly, that we've seen turn around so dramatically over the last couple of months. Whether you get any sort of return to those names.
Yeah.
In a meaningful way, hard to see right now. But that's right. When everything sort of turned, when they finally gave it up after what many would have said was speculative excess during the course of much of the year, but they kept going up, the momentum trade.
Right, and I think that we have, it's very sobering because obviously Apple's come down a great deal, but it's up very long term. Facebook come down a little, but it's up a lot. We haven't heard much from Alphabet. Amazon, the stories continue to be positive. And it hasn't really mattered that stock's nowhere back to where it was. I still think Apple's the key to this market, so to speak. J&J's now lost $50 billion in value. I am now willing to say that I think that's just wrong. That's just wrong. I will have Gorski on tonight. Am I saying buy J&J? When you do this kind of thing, you know you're just putting your head in the lion's den. I think that we will find that J&J will be higher. In part because as I go through the lawsuits, I feel like that this turned out to be a way to be able to get a lot of people to sue. Obviously, that is not what Reuters' intention was or New York Times. They're reporting the stories they see. But this is a boon to the plaintiffs bar because now everybody who used Tao would probably like to create a giant class action suit that J&J will have to pay. I still don't think it'll amount to $50 billion. And remember, J&J has a huge amount of cash. A huge amount of cash flow. It's highly emotional. It's hard to bottom, but I think it's overdone.
By the way, guys, at the big board today, G-Zero Media, subsidiary of the Eurasia Group. Our friend Ian Bremmer on the podium today at the NASDAQ. Carson Wealth, the Northeast, celebrating its name change from Cornerstone Wealth Management.